No one wants to feel unattractive, you know? That's why they invented makeup. You know, fake pretty is better than real ugly. I think everyone can agree with that. Because everyone's vain to a certain degree. Everyone cares a little, unless you just roll out of bed every morning with, like, boogers all over your face, throw on your best burlap and just head out. Like, everyone cares a little. And you can't really say who's the most vain, you know? Is the 60-year-old man with a comb over any less vain than the 20-year-old girl with fake boobs and fake nails? No. He's still in front of the mirror every morning, like, man, still got it. He cares as much as anyone. Everyone cares, because your image is the first thing people see about you. They judge you on that. Whether that's right or wrong, it is helpful. You see the guy with the pop-collared shirt and the puka shell necklace and spiked up frosted tip hair, you're like, well, I hate that guy. It's helpful. If we all wore futuristic spacesuits, you wouldn't be able to tell who's a douchebag. Luckily, we dress ourselves, and that saves time. You know? I think you just grow up hearing, like, oh, don't judge a book by its cover. And that's a nice thing to say to your kids, but you gotta be careful. If you tell your kid, hey, don't judge a book by its cover, and then your kid ends up being abducted by a guy in a mustache and a members-only jacket driving a van, you kinda did that to your kid. You know? You need to tell him, hey, judge that book by its creepy-ass cover. Stay the hell out of that van. That's just good parenting. Like, why do we even still sell vans? Everyone knows what happens in there. Terrible things. If you sell someone a van, especially if they have a mustache, you may as well just throw in a free bag of candy.
Look at him, buddy.
Everyone cares a little about their appearance. So, like, I had a weird image thing a while ago, like a vein issue. I got a bad haircut. Not this one. This one's pretty sweet. But I got my hair cut at an all-black barber shop for the last time ever. And I know that sounds extraordinarily racist, unless you're a black dude. Because then you know I'm not the normal clientele you see at an all-black barber shop. And every guy in there knew that. When I walked in, every guy in the shop was just like, really? It's not like I can come walking in like, oh, hey, how's it going? Oh, sorry, I don't let black people cut my hair. See you later. Just leave. And it's not like they can see me walking in and be like, no white people, get out. But that's what should have happened. We both knew I was in the wrong spot, but neither side could say anything because we didn't want to seem racist. So then there's just this awkward standoff where we're both just like, wow, what the hell, give it a shot. It's terrible. It's like an anti-hate crime. It should be okay to say, like, oh, wrong spot, but I'm not racist. See you later, no hard feelings, but you can't do that. You gotta pretend to, like, look at the prices. Yeah, it seems about right. Yeah. Just terrible.